Hi, I'm Angela Clark with Threadwaggle Quilting in Raleigh, North Carolina. Today I want to talk to you about how Quilt Path looks at the designs that it's trying to quilt for you. So when you're looking at the screen, you're going to notice that my row for my pantograph has been put inside of a green box. That green box is all Quilt Path cares about when it's trying to quilt your design. It doesn't care what's inside the green box. It's just going to stitch whatever that is. The green box itself is how it places your designs. So when you are doing a pantograph, it is going to put the entire row inside of a green box. The two sides of the green box are going to be whatever's on the farthest to the right and the left, right? The two horizontal green lines are the top and the bottom. So it's the very top design that's going to, or the very top stitch, right, that's going to be quilted on that design is the top of the green box. Same thing on the bottom. Once you understand that, you can place absolutely anything with the program. Okay, so let's say I just stitched this row and it went to the next row, which is going to be an offset row, right? On this one, it would be pretty easy because the top left, top center, and top right are all at the top of diamonds, right? So if I had just quilted the row above this and I lost power and I came back in, it would be a lot easier for me to figure out where it was going, it needed to be placed, because I can see the points on the design. And that seems to make it a little bit easier for us to figure out. Let's look at one, the next row, right? That isn't going to be that easy, because when you go to place this row, I'm just going to center it real quick for us. You're trying to place in void space in all three places. So how would I figure out where that was? Well, if I've stitched enough of the row that I have at least one of the highest points, I can drop a piecing ruler down. I use those, eighth inch acrylic rulers that we cut with when we're piecing quilts, because they're long and skinny, long, skinny, and not very thick, right? So they're easy for me to put down on the surface of the quilt. I personally like a 6 inch by 24 inch one when I'm doing this, honestly, if I can get a 3 inch by 18, that's great too. So something that's skinny and long, and I will match it up with what's sewed here. There's actually going to be stitching here because the design above was making the chevron out here, right? So I'm going to see line stitching straight up and down that join those together. So one of my lines is going to be matched up with stitching. The other line, if I have at least one of those points, I'm going to drop my ruler onto the point, slide it over until the edge touches the part that's stitched up and down, and the corner of the ruler, right, would be where I need to place my row. That would be the top left corner, the one that I would use with this, the top left yellow flag button. And if you look at these buttons, it is showing you this green box. It's trying to tell you everything I'm doing has to do with a green box. I'm showing you what I'm doing to the green box with these buttons. Okay. So once you understand how, to find out where the green box would be on your row, you can place even things that are very organic, that don't feel like they would have, be as easy. All you have to do is find the highest point in that row, move it out to the left or right, whichever one you can see the stitching on the row above it for, right? And wherever it touches, that's going to be the top of your green box. If you don't have any stitching, right, and you can see how far you need to go down. So if I didn't have any stitching, I would go up to above this diamond right here and measure with my ruler what the drop is, how far down the point needed to be. So the top of the green box for this row, how far down was it from the bottom of this. So I'd be looking at it, right, in relationship to how it would look right here, if that makes sense. And then, right, I would measure that with my physical ruler. I would take the, mark where the bottom of the little space is, pull all the way out. It would be actually right here. So I'd be marking where the top is, right like there, and pulling my ruler out. And I put a piece of tape under it in that point, and I mark where the corner of my ruler is, because then I need to measure down and put a second mark so that I can actually place the row. Okay. But if you understand this green box, you can get it to place absolutely anything. And it's not just in Pantograph. It does the same thing in placement setting. So let's switch over to there real quick, and I'll show you that as well. Now we're in the placement setting part of the program. And what I want to show you is how Quilt Path looks at a design. So if I go up to my settings, I'm going to switch over to block real quick. So it's set to block stretch. And what I want to show you is how Quilt Path is seeing the design that's on your screen. So I'm going to go ahead and come up and just tap on my screen and then start setting this block. And you're going to notice that it put it in a green box as well. So what this tells me is that if I was to mark these two opposite points on my quilt, so I'm marking a block, there is going to be no stitching in the corners. This is actually a hexagon, right? So if I have a hexagon on my screen and I want, or on my quilt top, right? And I want what's on my screen to fit into it, how do I do that? I'm going to make a template. So what I'm going to do is I like overhead projector sheets because I can get them in 8.5 by 11. I can tape two together if I need to do a bigger block, or tape more than two together. I've also used Mylar that I got in much bigger sheets. You can use plexiglass if you have a piece of plexiglass and your needle will go over it, right? So there's, or a page protector that you split in half, right? So there's lots of different ways you can get a clear piece to put down on the surface of the quilt. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to set my piece of plastic on the quilt, and my quilt path is, my long arm is going to be away from this area. And I am going to take typically a black marker. And I usually do this with permanent marker. Just be really careful that you are marking on the plastic and not on your quilt top, right? And I will mark the corners, the six corners of this. So I'll mark where the start point is. I'll come up and mark the top one. And I'm just putting little dots in the six corners. Then I'm going to take this away and I'm going to use that ruler that I have. And I'm going to put it down and I'm going to draw the hexagon shape. I'm just going to connect my six points. Okay. Once I do that, I'm then going to draw the green box. So I'm going to switch from a black marker to a green marker. And the reason that I do that is so that I'm actually making myself conscious that the green box is there, is the nicest way to put it. When I first started this out, I had to have a visual reference that this is what I was trying to do. So I'm going to mark the left and right sides, which are easy to see in this design because you have a straight line stitching right here, right? And you're going to have straight lines going up the side, and they're going to more than likely touch the edges of my piecing line in a perfect world. Okay, so I'm going to mark those and I'm going to extend them out, and I'm not going to worry about how far I'm extending them out, really. I just want them to be a little bit taller than where, than this is, right? Because I'm going to do that in just a second. But I'm going to start out by extending these straight out so that I get those straight. And then I'm going to turn my ruler 90 degrees. I'm going to find this point, and I'm going to make sure that I'm keeping straight on these two lines. And I'm going to draw my green box across the top, do the same thing on the bottom, and draw my green line on the bottom. Wherever they cross in the corner, those lines that I've drawn, those are the points that I'm going to mark. In this case, I would be marking two if I was doing a 2-point set. But look, if I come in here and do a 4-point set, when I first change, you're not going to see the green box. But as soon as I start clicking, that green box is going to show back up. So if my block is a little bit wonky, right, it lets me say, oh, I really want you to come in a little bit. And I can torque my design so that it will actually fit into my space. So when we talk about making templates to place things in Quilt Path, all we are really doing is showing ourselves visibly or where the green box is in relationship to what we are trying to place. And guys, I am telling you, if you can get yourself to understand the green box and how what Quilt Path is trying to show you, it will make your life so much easier and you can place absolutely anything with the program. Okay, so we're going to continue talking about the green box in future videos. If you liked this video, please like the video so that we know that you liked it. Subscribe to our channel for more information about Quilt Path and Quilters Creative Touch. And you can also like us on Facebook and on Instagram. We're Threadwaggle on Instagram and APQS Raleigh on Facebook. And we would love to know what kind of videos you'd like to see in the future. Thanks a lot, guys.